Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Kentucky Cheesecake Brownies, and that's exactly what the name implies. It's going to be a pan that is composed of brownies on the bottom and cheesecake on the top. And when we cut it into squares, you'll get some of both. This is a good Kentucky recipe, and I hope you enjoy it. So let me tell you something about the preparation, and then we'll get started. You'll need to have some chocolate ready, and what I have here are 2 bags of semisweet chocolate chips, and you'll notice that they are 12 ounces each, so that's 24 ounces, so that would be 1.5 pounds that you need of chocolate chips, and semisweet will be the best for you. Now, I've already melted these. You can see there might be a lump here or there because I didn't want these to be just boiling hot, and I've let them sit for a bit. You can see that the water, it has a little steam coming from it, but not too much. We'll need this later on, so you start that first thing so you'll have it sitting there ready for when you need it. Now let's come down here to our large mixing bowl. I have my mixer, and you'll see that I have 1.5 sticks of butter, and I use salted butter, and that would be equivalent to 6 ounces. 1 stick is 4 ounces. So we have 1.5 sticks, that's 2 ounces more, so 6 ounces of butter. You could use margarine if you prefer. I'm going to add 1.5 cups of granulated white sugar to that. And then what I need to do is cream that. And I use a mixer to do the creaming, so it's going to be a little noisy. Let me get started. I'll go away, get this done, and come back. Now we're ready to add our eggs. There are going to be a lot of eggs in this because we have cheesecake going on top of our brownies, but the brownies will be the bottom portion, so we have to start those first. Sometimes I call these bluegrass brownies because it's very Kentucky oriented, and I think you'll see why in a minute. I'm going to use 6 eggs, and I have them already broken and put into a little bowl here, and what I need to do is mix them in about 1 at a time. So I'll just pour until I get 1 yolk in and try to scrape that edge a little bit and then start mixing. I've gotten all 6 eggs beat into our mixture. That's what it looks like. And I had to change to a bigger bowl. I had just a large mixing bowl, and I thought it would handle everything, but there is a lot of flour that goes in here, and then we have our chocolate that I talked about earlier. I have 6 cups of flour. It takes a large mixing cup to get all of that in, and what I want to do is to pour it in probably a little at a time, and I'm going to hand mix it instead of using the mixer. It's better just to let it get a little stiffer all the time, so just a little bit at a time. I'll come back when I have it all mixed in. I have the flour pretty well mixed in, and I have some more things to put in, so I just didn't worry about getting it all the way done. This is self-rising flour. Now, you can get by with all-purpose flour if you want to use that. It doesn't really matter in this recipe. Brownies are fairly compact, and you don't need them light and fluffy like a cake. So I'm using self-rising flour, but you may use either kind. Now, the next thing that I'm going to add is some vanilla. This is vanilla extract, and I need 1 tablespoon. So this is the time that we want to put our vanilla in. And at this point, you need to make a decision as to whether you'd like to put some whiskey in it. This is bourbon whiskey, Maker's Mark. It doesn't have to be this brand, but we like this brand, and we did a field trip to Maker's Mark, and this is the bottle that I dipped. I always show it when I'm using any bourbon whiskey. But anyway, I'll leave this up to Rick. Do you want to use the bourbon whiskey this time?
You're going to make him think I'm drunk.
That's a yes, isn't it?
I don't even like whiskey except in cooking, so yes.
Yeah, actually that's true. He loves bourbon balls, and before we started making bourbon balls, he wouldn't even drink bourbon whiskey. He would maybe have a beer occasionally, or maybe some wine or something like that, but it's not his favorite. But we're going to make these Kentucky style, truly. But if you don't want that, you can substitute 1/3 cup, which is what this is, of orange juice, or you could use apple juice, or you could use any fruit juice, and that will give it the same amount of liquid, make it nice and moist, and you won't miss the bourbon. Okay, I'm going to stir this up and try to get it a little nicer, and then we'll be putting in the chocolate. So I'll be back in a minute. I'm continuing to combine my brownie mixture. I think it's going to be a little easier if I go ahead and put the melted semi-sweet chocolate chips. So remember, this was 2 bags worth, and I've had it over this hot water. It's not really steaming much anymore, so it's not going to cook anything, but it will help me, I think, a little bit in terms of making this easier to blend. So I'm just going to put all of that in and then go back to the procedure of combining the mixture. So just a second, and I'll come back to you with it all blended together. Here's the completed brownie mixture. And what I need to do is to put it in a greased or sprayed, in my case I sprayed it with canola oil. It's 13 by 9 by 2, and we're going to put that in. I think I can just pour it in and then spread it out. This is very heavy because it's quite a large mixture, and it was a little bit difficult to actually combine, and there'll be places where it isn't completely combined. You can work with those, or you can just leave it with kind of a marbled look, either way. So what I need to do is work on this and spread it out a bit, and then I'll be back. I have my brownie mixture in my pan, and you can see it fills it up pretty well, but I'm still going to put the cheesecake layer on the top, so we have to mix it together. So I'm going over the other end and get started. In my mixing bowl, I have 3 containers of cream cheese. And I picked the fat-free variety. You can use fat-free or regular. And you need it at room temperature, so you should be able to put a fork through it like that. And it should mix very easily. So I could use a fork and mash it down, but I'm going to use a mixer, and I'm going to beat it until it's light and fluffy. Then right here, I have some sugar. And this is just regular white granulated sugar, 1 1/2 cups. Once I have fluffy cream cheese, I will start adding in the sugar a little at a time, and when I come back, I'll have the sugar incorporated into the cream cheese. I have my cream cheese and sugar light and fluffy, and the next thing I'm going to add is eggs. Now, my recipe calls for 6 whole eggs, and you just put 1 at a time. With them being jumbo, I decided to make it 5. So if you, depending on the size of the egg you're using, you might make it 5 or 6. So you'll just pour 1 of those in and then use your mixer to beat it in, and continue to do that until all 5 or 6 are in there. So here is the lovely mixture that you get once you have the eggs incorporated. We have a few more things to go. I need to put in a little bit of flour. It can be plain flour or self-rising. You need 2 tablespoons. So I'm just going to sprinkle that around. Didn't want to get it started. And then I guess I'll stir that first before adding anything else. I'll be stirring it some more, but I want to show you the next thing I'm adding is vanilla. I need 1 tablespoon. This was a tablespoon measure, and I poured it into something larger so it wouldn't fall over. So that's 1 tablespoon of vanilla going in there. These two I'm mixing into my main mixture. It's going to take a second, so I'll be right back to finish it up. The last thing to go into this mixture is sour cream, and I've chosen a fat-free sour cream. You need 1/2 cup, so just put that in and fold it into the mixture. So you want to just kind of turn your bowl and start stirring, but you don't want to whip it in, just kind of fold it so it gets blended gently into this mixture. And that's going to take me a second or two, so I'll be right back to finish up what goes in the oven. And here is our wonderful cheesecake mixture that is going to be poured on top of our bluegrass brownies. So I'm just going to let this come along down like this. Those specks in there are little bits of vanilla that clung to the flour, I think. You don't need to worry about those, but I've done this a little hurriedly, so you could probably do a little better than I have here. But just get this in here, most of it at least. and then even it out. And then it's going to be baking in an oven that is set to 375 degrees. So spreading evenly to all corners. It's going to look like this. And we're going to bake it kind of like cheesecake, kind of like brownies, because we have a combination of the two. So I'll let you know when it's done and how long it has taken, but we're going into the oven at 375 degrees. Here are our bluegrass cheesecake brownies straight from the oven. And you'll see that it puffs up a little bit, and you'll probably be worried that it's going to run over, but it will not. I did put some aluminum foil in the bottom of my oven, and I also put a layer over it just in case it wanted to brown up too much. And I never really took either one of those out, so I just wanted to tell you about that. Now, what needs to happen with this is that it needs to sit for a while so it can cool off. It should be completely cool. And then what I'm going to do is cut it into 2-inch squares, and then we can serve it on a serving plate, and it's ready to eat. And here's the serving of our bluegrass cheesecake brownies. Hope you like them.